Welcome students. In our today's class, we are going to read a short story by R.K.D. Gaither. Okay. Name of the story is Chuck and Gig's Train Journey. Before starting reading the story, we should always read the introduction part. So, let us begin. This passage is from the book Chuck and Gig. Chuck, aged 7, and Gig, aged 6, are two brothers who live in Moscow with their mother. So there are two brothers. They are two brothers who live in Moscow with their mother. Their father, who is away for work in Siberia, asks his family to join him for the New Year celebrations. So Chuck's and Gig's father called them for New Year celebration in Siberia, where he works. Receiving his telegram, the children and their mother packed their belongings and set off for Siberia. Read on to find out what happens during their train journey. So, let us begin. The next day, after receiving the telegram, they packed their belongings and set off for Siberia. Now, our story is starting with their train journey. The next day, they left. But since the train drew out of the station at a very late hour, the windows were black and Chuck and Gig didn't see anything of interest. So when they started their train journey, it was night time and the windows were black. There were no light outside and Chuck and Gig didn't see anything that may pique their interest. Okay. In the middle of night, Gig woke up feeling thirsty. So in the middle of the night, Gig woke up. The younger brother woke up feeling thirsty. He was feeling thirsty. So though the little lamp on the ceiling had been turned off, everything around Gig, the glass dancing up and down on the white cloth of the table. So the train was moving, so everything was shaking. So it seems to Gig that everything is dancing up and down. The yellow orange that now looked green, and the face of the mother who was fast asleep was bathed in bluish light. So there was a bluish light coming, and the face of the mother seems to Gig is kind of blue. Through the window, Gig saw a giant moon. Why the moon was giant? Maybe it was a full moon night, so the moon seemed to Gig a giant moon. He was quite certain now that the train was speeding through the high mountains. So he was quite sure that the train was speeding through the high mountains. From where the moon was much nearer. So it seemed to Gig that the moon was much nearer. He woke mother and asked for some water. So Gig asked his mother, woke his mother and asked her for some water. But she asked him to eat a piece of orange instead. Strange. He asked for water, but what his mother offered him? His mother offered him a piece of orange instead. Instead of giving him water, he offered him orange. Gig pouted, but broke off a section of orange. He pouted, he make a kind of face and broke off a section of orange. He didn't feel like sleeping. So he was a kid of 6 years and he was not feeling to sleep. He was not feeling having a feel to sleep. He shook Chuck to wake him up. Okay. He was shaking Chuck to wake him up, his brother. Chuck only snorted angrily and went on sleeping. But his brother denied to wake up and he angrily went on sleeping. Gig then put on his boots. Now he is putting on his boots and he will going for his adventure now. Open the door went out into the corridor. It was a long, narrow corridor. There were seats attached to the wall. Okay, so in the corridor, there were seats attached for people to sit, and they shot back with a bang when you got them off. 10 more doors opened out on the corridor. They were all a glossy red and had shiny brass handles. So how the doors looks like? They were colored in a glossy red color, and they had handles which are made out of shiny brass. Okay, brass is a material that is made out of mixed of two materials. Okay, I have given this in your study notes also. Read that. Gek sat
on one seat, then on another, then on a third, and so on until he found himself at the end of the coach. But at the very moment Potter came in with his lantern and scolded Gek for making so much noise when people were sleeping. Now the Potter came. Porter means the person whose job is to help 10 passengers. He came in and he scolded Gek for what? For Gek was making noise while other people were sleeping. Okay? As soon as the porter had gone, Gek hurried back to the compartment. Now he was scared and he was hurrying back to his compartment. He opened the door after a few tries and then closed it carefully so not to wake up his mother, and jumped into the soft bed. Finding fat old Chuck spread all over the bed, Gek poked him in the side to make him move over. So he thought that Gek has take over all the seats and he has no place to sit. He poked Chuck to move over. But horrors! Instead of chubby Chuck, Gek saw an angry mustache face of a strange man. It looked at him and barked gruffly. "Who's that pushing me?" Gek let out a howl that brought all the passengers down from their berths. Now, Now, he got scared and he started to cry that has waked up all the passengers. The light was switched on. And when Gek saw that he had walked into a wrong compartment, he began to howl louder than ever. He started to cry very loudly. When they realized what had happened, everybody started laughing. Okay, now all the passengers were laughing as they realized that he has come to their compartment, thinking it to be his own compartment. The man with mustache pulled on his clothes and took Gek back to his own compartment. Gek quietly tucked under his blanket and fell asleep. Okay? Okay, that's all for today. We'll cover the next part in our next class. Okay, students, bye.